This episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory will continue looking at the realm of the galaxies and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. Messier 84. Messier 86. And the Eyes Galaxies. All right, let's go star hopping. Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 19 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm absolutely joyous to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. In this episode of Star Hopping, we'll continue our exploration of the realm of the galaxies. This is the second in the series of three episodes where we'll be checking out the Virgo supercluster of galaxies, because there's just so much to cover. In the first episode, we established our guidepost star of six Comae Berenices as our starting point. I'll only lightly review our star hopping methods to get there, so if you missed last week's episode, it might be a good idea to go back and familiarize yourself. Just click on the thumbnail below to play that episode first. This week we'll go on a true galaxy hop, where we'll traverse Markarian's chain, a group of 11 galaxies that form a long arc in the dead center of the realm. These galaxies were named after the Armenian astronomer Benik Markarian, who discovered in the 1960s that these galaxies all appear to be moving together in space and all give off a similar ultraviolet light signature. Some of these galaxies are very faint, pushing 12th magnitude, so you need a moderate-sized telescope and a reasonably dark sky to pick them up in your eyepiece. Also, you'll need to use an eyepiece that gives you the lowest magnification and consequently the largest field of view. This is generally a 35 to 40 millimeter eyepiece. Eyepiece focal length has an inverse relationship with magnification. The higher the eyepiece focal length, the lower the magnification. So let's get started by moving to our guidepost star, 6 Comae Berenices. If you remember, we started on the bright star Denebola, then moved down to 5th magnitude Omicron Leonis, and then 5 degrees further downward to 6 Comae. Now we're ready to move to our first target, Messier 84.
Star hopping target number 1.
To locate M84, we have to make a couple hops to first a 6th magnitude star and then a 7th magnitude star. From 6 Comae, make your first move to the first 6th magnitude star, which lies about 3/4 degree straight down. Now move about another 3/4 degree, this time to the lower right, to that 7th magnitude star I mentioned. So now we're going to do a leap of faith to the target galaxy, so make sure you can get back to that star we're on right now. Move down and slightly right a little over a degree, and you'll see one and possibly two galaxies right away. These are M84 and M86, both elliptical galaxies, with M86 being the lower and larger of the two. Now look closely. In the same field, just to the right of the two ellipticals, you may see an 11th magnitude edge-on galaxy, NGC 4388. Then, look between that edge-on and the two ellipticals, and you might spy a 12th magnitude elliptical, NGC 4387. Now, if M84 and M86 were a pair of eyes, and the edge-on 4388 were a mouth, then you have a celestial face with a nose, NGC 4387. This group is nicknamed, surprisingly, the face. This image taken by the Canada-France-Hawaii telescope on Mauna Kea shows the four galaxies in amazing detail, and you can see the group smiling at you. The face is situated at the top end of Markarian's chain. Now we'll proceed on our galaxy hop to our next target, known as the eyes.
Star hopping target number 2.
Okay, let's head downward even further into the realm toward the Eyes Galaxies. Center your eyepiece on M86, which is the lower of the pair of elliptical galaxies that we looked at. Then drift down to the lower left about a half degree, and you'll run into a pair of spiral galaxies. This pair was nicknamed the Eyes by the 19th century observer L.S. Copeland, because their likeness to a pair of eyes is emphasized by the fact that their long axes were oriented in the same direction, right? The smaller of the pair is NGC 4435, which shines at magnitude 10.9, and it's generally seen as an oval with a bright core. The second larger spiral is NGC 4438, which gleams a little brighter at magnitude 10.1. If you look closely, you might see its strange shape. It's being deformed by the gravity of its close neighbor. So lots more to see in Markarian's chain. Onward and downward we go.
Star hopping target number 3.
So we have the next pair of targets in our galaxy hop lying just about 3/4 of a degree to the lower left. So slowly slide your scope that way and you'll pick up the small spiral NGC 4443 at magnitude 11 and the elliptical NGC 4458 at magnitude 12. 4458 is smaller with a round shape and it's a bit fainter than 4443. Next, move about a half degree again to the lower left and you'll see 10th magnitude NGC 4473, another elliptical galaxy, so it'll also appear generally round in shape. Lastly, move about a half degree to the left and you'll pick up 10th magnitude NGC 4477, a spiral galaxy. Okay, one more target if you're so inclined. You're here, right? So you might as well. This will be a final reward to your trip down Markarian's chain. Move a degree to the left, and you'll see the beautiful spiral galaxy Messier 88, shining at a comparatively bright magnitude 9.6. M88 is one of the more rewarding galaxies in the Virgo cluster for smaller scopes. It's a very compact spiral set at an angle of 36 degrees to our line of sight. It looks just like a miniature Andromeda galaxy. Phew! So wasn't that exciting? Boy, you saw 11 galaxies in the period of a few minutes. If you use star charts like SkySafari here, you can easily make some side trips off the chain to find even more galaxies. Just make sure you can move back to your last reference point before you stray too far. Again, it's easy to get lost in the realm. Okay, to review. We started off from our guidepost star 6 Coma Berenices, and then after hopping a few faint stars, we located the face, consisting of M84 and M86 for the eyes, NGC 4387 for the nose, and NGC 4388 for the mouth. Then we moved down and picked up NGC 4435 and 4438, known as the eyes. Then we continued down farther, picking off 4 more fainter NGC galaxies, and finally ending up at the gorgeous spiral bonus galaxy, Messier 88. Quite a ride, huh? So that does it for this week's episode. You can find the show notes on our website at kpobservatory.org/sh019, where you can comment and leave any questions that you may have. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week to finish off our exploration of the realm of the galaxies.
I'm Cassie, and I hope you've enjoyed star hopping around the Milky Way. We'll continue to bring you these video astronomy tutorials every week on Thursday, and in their podcast format on Fridays. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky at the time we post them on the internet. The reason we create these videos and podcasts is to help beginning amateur astronomers learn the sky and get more enjoyment out of their telescopes and astronomy in general. If you have any requests for potential targets in the night sky that you would like to see us discuss, just let us know down in the comments section below or on our website blog. Don't miss our free field notes for this episode, basically the script of the show, with all the images and star charts we use for our star hopping activities. You can get them for free at kpobservatory.org/fieldnotes. If this is the first time you're checking out star hopping, and if you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to our channel by clicking the big yellow button, click the thumbs up on the video, and please share this tutorial out to your friends who like looking at stars. Also, as I just mentioned, please feel free to leave any question or comment below, and we'll be sure to respond quickly. Please follow KPO on Facebook, where we post all of our astronomical digital images, and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. We'd love to hear from you to discuss all this great stuff up in the sky. All the links to these places in cyberspace, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value, and if you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a small amount per video, you can support our efforts, and help us make even more great astronomy tutorials, just like this one. So bye for now, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.